Hey, it's 104 degrees, and if that doesn't wipe you out, a jammed weapon will. Remember, guys, keep it clean and keep your head low.
Oh, when the sun beats down and burns the tar up on the roof, and your shoes get so hot, you wish your tired feet were fireproof.
Hi, Mom. Well, I'm fine today, and I hope that you're in good shape also. Today, I am swimming, washing, and taking in the sun. The beach is great. The sand is white, and the sky is clear. Boy, I wish every day was like this. And I wouldn't have any problems while I'm here.
American casualties in Vietnam, killed and wounded, now exceed 300,000. More than 39,000 killed and more than 258,000 wounded. Here's a report from NBC.
Dear folks, this is your on-the-spot correspondent in the Big Nam reporting.
Hi, honey. I had a hell of a day yesterday.
Dear Sue, thank you for the wingtips. Only one question. Where do I wear them in Vietnam?
I'm sitting down to write of my love for you and the horrors of war.
Actually, I'm writing because I have to, or go out of my mind. Things happen over here,
Mom,
you just can't.
I appreciate all your letters. For a while, as I read your letters, I'm a normal person. I'm not killing people or worried about being killed.
Darling, believe me, I try not to skip a day in writing you. Whether or not I get a letter determines if it's a good day or not.
And here is the news. Three communist PT boats attacked an American destroyer off the coast of Vietnam yesterday, and today President Johnson's response was hard and tough. He has ordered the U.S. Navy to continue patrolling there, and if they are attacked, to destroy their attackers.
To any armed attack upon our forces, we shall reply. To any in Southeast Asia who ask our help in defending their freedom, we shall give it.
Can't win in Asia. So I am not going to go along with this kind of a program in South Vietnam, at least with my vote, but in my judgment, is going to kill needlessly untold numbers of American boys and for nothing.
here it is. We've been told that our whole company will be shipping out to Vietnam after advanced infantry training. Our company commander and our battalion and brigade commanders told us that there's no sense in trying to fool ourselves. We're going for sure. The only thing that makes me mad is how do they expect you to tell your parents? I don't mind going, but there are some guys here who just won't make it. And I don't think they'll make it out alive. Your son, Bob. P.S. Tell Mom not to worry. It's nothing I can't handle.
Dear uncle and aunt, some people wonder why Americans are in Vietnam. The way I see the situation, I would rather fight and stop communists in South Vietnam than in Kincaid, Humboldt, Blue Mound, or Kansas City. And that's just about what it would end up being. The price for victory is high when life cannot be replaced. But I think it is far better to fight and die for freedom than to live under oppression and fear. Your nephew, Jack.
What state are you from?
Philadelphia, sir.
North Carolina. Charlotte. Yeah, I know it well. Well, good luck to you, lad.
Dear John, well, in 360 days, I'll be home. Try not to worry too much about me. I know that will be difficult, but it doesn't do anyone any good. Love, Bobby.
I finally got to my unit yesterday. Our mission is to find VC and kill them. I should be operating like this for the next 2 months before I get a chance to take a shower and sleep in a bed. What a life. There are absolutely no comforts in our job. I carry nothing but a razor and a bar of soap for comfort. We wear the only clothes we have and wash them in rivers and streams as we cross them. You were right. I managed to get myself right in the middle of it all.
Dear Tom, hi, how are you? I hope all is well at home. Everything's okay here. My whole squad is all a bunch of screwballs. Eddie's running around now with an insect bomb, cursing the bugs. The mosquitoes that come out at night are man-eaters, but the insect repellent keeps them off. It's safe in the daytime. We stand out in the open or work on the bunker. We can run up and down the hill with no worries. But at night, we gotta stay in the bunkers as snipers sneak in. Dennis. P.S. Send some Kool-Aid. Water here tastes like shit.
I have a booby trap, tripwire tied onto a branch, grenade on the end of the tripwire, a spoon is out.
Dear Mom and Dad, the way we move without contact, you begin to wonder if the VC are even out there. All the time you know they are. The great frustration is that they don't come out and fight.
Anyone over here who walks more than 50 feet through elephant grass should automatically get a Purple Heart. Try to imagine grass possessing razor-sharp edges, 8 to 15 feet high, so thick as to cut visibility to 1 yard. Then try to imagine walking through it while all around you are men possessing the latest automatic weapons who desperately want to kill you. You'd be amazed at how much a man can age on one patrol.
We're all scared. One can easily see this emotion in the eyes of each individual. One might hide it with his mouth, while another might hide it with his actions. But there's